Hello students, today we will be seeing the gross anatomical features of the spleen. Now what we see here is a specimen of the spleen. Now spleen is a hemolymphoid organ. Basically it filters blood as well as it filters the lymph. Now where does it lie in the body? Situation: it is situated in two regions of the abdomen. It predominantly lies in the left hypochondriac region, and one third of it can also enter into the epigastric region. So those are the two regions where it is situated. Then let us see what is the axis of the spleen. The spleen lies in the axis which is running parallel to the 10th left rib. Let us now go to see what is the shape of the spleen. As you can see here, the spleen appears like a flattened oblong shaped specimen, or it could also be called as a tetrahedral shaped organ. Soft and friable, purple in color. Then we see the measurements of the spleen. It is about 1 inch in thickness, 3 inches in width, 5 inches in length, and weighs about 7 ounces, is seen running parallel to the 9th, 10th and 11th ribs on the left side. This can be remembered as the Harry's dictum, which says all odd numbers from 1 to 11 and only one even number, that is number 10. So 1 inch in thickness, 3 inches in width, 5 inches in length, 7 ounces in weight, and it runs between the 9th and 11th ribs on the left side, and its axis runs parallel to the long axis of the 10th rib. Now let us see the morphological features. It has got two ends or two poles, an anterior end and a posterior end. It has got two surfaces, a diaphragmatic surface which rests on the diaphragm, and a visceral surface which is facing towards the other viscera, and three borders: a superior border, an inferior border, and an intermediate border which runs through the hilum of the spleen. Now with this orientation, let us see how do we hold the spleen in the normal anatomical position. Look at the borders and find out a border which is having 2 to 3 notches. The notched border as well as the sharp border is the superior border. Intermediate border runs through the hilum, and the inferior border is ill defined. It is smooth. So that tells you this is superior and this is inferior. Then look at the two poles. The anterior pole is broad. Some books also mention it as a line or as a border, and not as an end. Whereas the posterior pole or the posterior end is pointed. So that tells you this is anterior and this is posterior. Now you rest this diaphragmatic surface on the palm of the left hand, and the three fingers, index, middle and ring finger, spread out as the 9th, 10th and 11th ribs. Hold it with the other two, with the thumb and little finger. And now you orient it, hold it back in such a way, the way it runs parallel to 10th rib on the left side. So this is how it lies in the body. This is how the normal position or normal anatomical position of the spleen is shown. Now let us see what are the relations of the spleen. Peritoneal relations: it has got the two ligaments, the gastrosplenic ligament and the linoleic ligament. Gastrosplenic ligament, which comes from the greater curvature of the stomach, meets the hilum and then splits to enclose the spleen. Again from the hilum, another ligament, the linoleic ligament, which goes from here posteriorly towards the anterior surface of the left kidney. These two are the peritoneal ligaments. One more ligament, which is the phrenicocolic ligament, on which the anterior end of the spleen rests. This ligament runs from the left colic flexure and goes towards the diaphragm. It supports the spleen from the inferior aspect. So those are the three ligaments related to the spleen: gastrosplenic ligament, linoleic ligament and phrenicocolic ligament. Then we want to see the visceral relations. Visceral relations of the diaphragmatic surface is going to be related to the diaphragm. It's also related more laterally to the lower border of the left lung, the left pleura, and below that to the left costo-diaphragmatic recess. And then more laterally would be the 9th, 10th and 11th ribs with the intercostal spaces and their contents between them. Those are the relations of the diaphragmatic surface. The visceral surface is related to the other abdominal viscera. This depression which we see here between the superior and the intermediate border is formed by the stomach, the fundus of the stomach. So this is the gastric impression. Then between the intermediate and the inferior border, this impression which you see on the posterior aspect is because of the left kidney. And we have one impression here nearer to the anterior end, and that is because of the left colic flexure. So that's the colic impression. Near the hilum, we have the relation to the tail of the pancreas, which is a content of the linoleic ligament. So these four are the visceral relations on this surface: the stomach, the left kidney, the left colic flexure and the tail of pancreas. Now let us see what are the structures seen at the hilum of the spleen. At the hilum of the spleen, we see the splenic artery which enters, the splenic vein which leaves and the afferent lymphatics which enter the spleen. Now we go on to see what is the blood supply of the spleen. Spleen is supplied by the splenic artery, which is a branch of the celiac trunk. Similarly, the veins which drain from the spleen ultimately drain into the splenic vein, which then joins to form the portal vein. The lymphatic drainage from the spleen goes into the pancreaticosplenic group of lymph nodes, and the nerve supply of the spleen is predominantly sympathetic, which comes from the celiac plexus, and it is vasomotor in nature. So this is how we have seen all the cross anatomical features of the spleen.